You're aware of how analytics, AI, and machine learning can improve everyday life. Targeting areas to apply those techniques, whether to solve a problem or address a challenge, starts with a story. Hey, I'm Robby Powell, product manager at SAS. Nearly every data story starts by identifying patterns and trends in historic data, then sharing those results to collaborate and build consensus. And finally, telling the story, because in the end, it's a journey from data to understanding. SAS Visual Analytics helps you along that journey by providing the tools and techniques, allowing you to explore, share, and tell the story. Explore using analytics that are built in and intelligently surfaced as you explore your data. As you discover insights, share them through a wide range of delivery and sharing options, such as using built-in visual analytics report distribution and sharing capabilities, through the SAS mobile apps for iOS, Android, and Windows 10. You can share your insights through the familiar Microsoft 365 apps, such as Excel, and share your insights by creating your own custom web and mobile experiences using the SAS SDKs. And finally, you can broadcast your insights to a small group or a huge global audience without worrying about scalability of your environment using SAS technologies that support infinite scale. And now I'm going to show you how, as I take you through a journey, starting with data and finishing by telling the story. I'm a business analyst at Aqua Bank, a small bank with branches throughout the United States. I've been asked to research ways to reduce write-off risk. We're passionate about our customers, as we know our success is completely based upon their success. So we want them to be as financially successful as possible. My findings will contribute to an executive portal we're creating. We also plan to publish the portal externally. I have access to our data science team. Their time is very valuable. I don't want to pull them in until I have something compelling to share. I also have access to our web development team, who will assist me with adding to the portal any insights that I discover. I start exploring an information catalog to understand the data assets I have available. I know I need data for the topics of credit and revenue. So first I'll search for data related to credit. I'm going to mark a few of these data sets as favorites to explore in visual analytics. Next, I'll search for data sources that contain information related to revenue. And I'll mark them as favorites as well. Now I've identified the data I want to explore. Jumping into SAS Visual Analytics, I begin exploring through interactive data discovery. Here's a report I've started that includes a scatter plot showing age and expected credit balance, as well as key values of important measures for the bank, and an explanation of a trend I've noticed through my exploration. The fit line shows that as the age of our clients increases, so does their expected credit balance. That makes sense. I also noticed that between the ages of early 40s to early 70s, the trend flattens out. This may be an indication that we should market more aggressively to those customers. I'm not done with this exploration yet. I want to see how credit limit is impacted by age and expected balance. All I need to do is drag that measure onto the visualization. And now I can see that as credit limit increases, so does expected credit balance. And as customer age increases, so does their credit limit. I'm always learning more about my data while using SAS Visual Analytics. Now I want SAS Visual Analytics to tell me what I should be looking at and help me explore my data by suggesting visualizations that are useful and relevant. Clicking on the Suggestions tab generates a series of visualizations for me to consider. I'll add this bar line graph of customer age and credit limit by state to a new page. When I refresh, new visualization objects are generated. I'll add two key value objects to the report, then perform some basic layout and housekeeping to create a nice visualization. And notice that as I select the bar line chart, the key value objects are updated automatically. Now I want some help understanding my data a bit better. I want visual analytics to explain write-off risk. And I'm presented with a guided explanation of write-off risk that includes natural language generated descriptions and interactive visualizations. Behind the scenes, multiple machine learning models, including decision tree and gradient boosting, have been run to produce this explanation. The factor credit score is a measure, so its relationship with write-off risk is represented by a scatter plot. Credit score group is a categorical value, so it's represented by a bar. State is a geographic item, and this relationship with write-off risk is represented by a geo-region object. Expanding the automated explanation object opens up even more explainability of the machine learning models that were run to produce these results, taking your storytelling to the next level. Write-off risk is the data item we ask visual analytics to explain. We see that 18 factors of my data have been screened and one of them was converted. More about that in a moment. And we see that a decision tree was created for every factor in my data to determine relative importance. Diving into more of the details, we see that account age was converted from a category to a measure. We can look at the relative importance of the factors. Again, a decision tree was created for each one of these factors to determine its importance. And we can look at anomalies or outliers. They've been detected in these three write-off risk values. This is also called out, the outliers are also called out in the natural language description above. I need to take my exploration a step further and find insights with a clear business impact, something I can share with my data science team. I'm going to ask Visual Analytics to cluster our users based on write-off risk. And here I see that five clusters have been identified. The parallel coordinate chart allows us to see how the various clusters are unique as well as the similarities between them. Cluster one has a low write-off risk, account ages from old to new, mostly adults with a wide range of transaction amounts. Cluster two differs by being mainly new accounts with lower transaction amounts. Cluster three is our older customers. Cluster four is our middle-aged customers. And finally, cluster five, these are our high write-off risk customers. These are the customers we need to reach out to and help them become more financially responsible. Our data scientists now need to operationalize this information to inform our marketing team of the various financial programs that need to be shared with each of these defined customer groups. Visual Analytics provides multiple options for sharing. You can choose copy link from the overflow menu of the explanation object to produce a link you can share in Microsoft Teams or email that goes directly to the visualization. You can also access copy link to share a link to the entire report. Or you can use the Visual Analytics share capability and specify individual users or groups you want to share the report with. You can also specify read-only or read and edit permissions. I've shown you the Visual Analytics visual interface. Now I'm going to introduce you to the conversational user interface. This chatbot connects directly to the AquaBank report we've been going through together. How to better explore, share, and tell the story than by using your voice. How many customers does the bank have? And here we see that the bank has 1.2 million happy customers. Which is the best performing card product? Here we see that AquaSky is the best performing card product with 66 million in revenue and 357,000 customers. The chatbot has also generated a question for us asking if we want to know about worst performing card products. We do, so we'll go ahead and click on that button and the bot asks the question on our behalf. And here we see that AquaCash is the worst performing card product. What was the revenue in 2020? Here we see in 2020, it was $212 million. What is the revenue over the years? And now we're presented with a bar chart that shows the revenue over the past 4 years and the partial revenue for this year, year to date, and a text explanation of the average revenue over the past 4 years at $227 million. The next thing I want to share with you is exploring, sharing, and telling the story using the SAS add-in for Microsoft 365. This add-in allows you to insert insights from your visual analytics reports directly into your Microsoft 365 documents. Select SAS from the Excel menu. Then Home. And your visual analytics reports are available. I'm going to open the AquaBank report and add the revenue and expenses key value objects to my Excel document. The open report is live and you can interact with it just as you can in Visual Analytics. I'm going to sort this customer table by state and then insert it into Excel. The table values and formats are inserted directly into the cells of the Excel document. At that point, you can interact with the data in your Excel document the same as you would any Excel data. And I'm going to specify a custom conditional format for these two columns. Now that I've explored my data and shared my insights, I'm ready to continue telling the story. The SAS SDKs allow you to embed insights you discover in Visual Analytics into your custom websites and mobile apps. Let me show you what that looks like. Like many business users, I start my workday by reviewing my company's corporate page, a location where all users get the latest information about the organization. I start my journey looking at some key stats. Each object you see is a SAS insight that's shared with me in a well-governed, secure manner, telling me a story about the bank's health. I can quickly see how AquaBank business is performing, new customers, revenue growth, expenses. As I select card products in the word cloud, I see the related key values are updated and the pie chart is updated. I can drill in to see the monthly data as well. These are not images of objects in your report. They are live. And an important and very exciting point to make is that the data backing these visualizations can either come directly from SAS VIA, providing a live connection to your data, or from an export package created through the Visual Analytics Publish capability to support infinite scale and offline support. Now, what you see here is a web page created using standard web technologies, HTML, CSS, JavaScript. That's it. The visualization objects, or insights as we like to call them, are coming from a Visual Analytics report. They are embedded into this web page using the SAS Visual Analytics SDK. Scrolling down, we're able to look at write-off risk by state and notice that there are three states performing badly related to write-off risk. We need to understand the causes of this poor performance. And we see two states with low write-off risk. Equally, we need to understand this as well and attempt to replicate it in other states. I'm really interested in understanding write-off risk in young married adults. These customers represent the future of our company, and it's important that we help them be successful. Filtering by young adult and married, I see the situation doesn't look very good. However, as I lower the credit limit, the outcome looks considerably better. I like this story. We should focus on working with young married couples to keep their credit limits manageable. Scrolling further down, I can interact with the automated explanation object we looked at earlier and analyze the factors that contribute to write-off risk through a highly visual, natural language generated description of write-off risk. So now you've seen how Visual Analytics enables you to explore, starting with exploring your data assets, interactively exploring your data using built-in analytics capabilities, and exploring by having a conversation with your data through a chatbot. After gaining insights, you can share them through built-in report scheduling and distribution, and the ability to generate and share links to the report through Microsoft 365, and through the Visual Analytics apps for iOS, Android, and Windows 10. And then tell the story through all of these methods and the incredible ability to embed insights into your custom websites using the Visual Analytics SDK and publish capabilities, allowing you to tell your story to as large an audience as you desire. I hope you found this presentation to be valuable as you explore, share, and tell the story, because in the end, it's a journey from data to understanding.